You want to go up there? Welcome, welcome. So what we are doing today is basically gonna launch a rocket ship. For that, we're gonna kind of break up the tech into at least two different sections. Bella. Rocket. I don't need that. Need rocket parts. 10 per minute. Shield. And no fiber compound yet. Chuck full of that. Basically six. Hey, expert, how are you doing today? both of those. Awesome. Good to see you doing well. Kerosene basically taken care of. Solid fuel will be taken care of. Hello, Lauren. How's Lauren doing today? Nope. What is your new job? Sounds exciting. No worries. So the base is going pretty good. We have 3 military outposts. We have a new oil field. And then we finally got our... Nice. That sounds like a lot of fun. And does a lot of good for humanity. Over here we have our nuclear power station that produces 1.1 gigawatts. We did get with logistic robots vamped up a lot last game. So we're talking triple capacity, movement speed went from like 95% up to 215%. So we're way, way ahead on logistic bots. We are almost done with the next computer. Well, done with the computer age and into the quantum age. Really not a lot left to do research. So I've just been researching artillery shell range. We are consuming huge amount of iron. That resource is now 100% dead. I actually don't think I have enough iron to sustain myself. Because, I mean, this whole section is just dead. Those are dead. Thanks, yeah. Each one of these blocks produces about 1,000 science per minute. Steam, Dark Age, Electronic Age, Computer Age. Just a strict bot base. I think my only belts are like right here. Other than that, I really don't have any belts anywhere. I don't have no trains. Well, these are the part of some of the original bot base stuff. Unfortunately, it's completely dead now. So those all need to be deleted. Yeah. Small, compact. Eventually everything a lot of these are still just waiting on upgrades and production speed modules. But it's all set for 1,000 per minute. And each of them produce what they need for that. And then I have my labs right here. Maxed out production module for what I can make at the moment. I doubt I'm making that much right now. Let me see. Final pack. I'm averaging about 36 right now. 75, 32, 24. But I'm only consuming in the 200s. But it's all built for the future anyways. Because for example, these are both missing their upgraded assembly machine. And missing more modules. This one is actually set for 1,200 per minute. Show me how much. 1/20th of that per second. Per minute, 1,200. This is currently at 795. 334. And then this is strictly just logistic bots. Ooh, 180 a minute. And not too bad overall. 1,000,000. I need to update that. It's so we have our rocket silo now. Let's go ahead and get Spidertrons with advanced exoskeleton. Heavy duty personal lasers, and then we'll go ahead and throw on another good measure. And that should get us into the next age. Not that we can do anything. So anyway, back to the rocket. I also want to make a satellite. A few people, yes. One guy joined last night, LSTNDFND. He has probably about, I think, 12,000 hours, he said. I don't know. A few people online I've also met that have been running this game for quite a while, but is also how many of it is idle hours, and how many of it is actual playing hours. Just a couple of hours a day over the course of 6 years, it really adds up. So Filipino, I got plenty of those. Solid fuel will be made. Guys should do light oil. I'm not worried about. Yeah, a couple is about 6 hours a day. Yeah, that seems about right. On a good weekend, I'll play about 14 hours. During the weekdays, I'll typically play let's see, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, about 5 hours. It definitely adds up quickly. Right, what's next on the list? I'll need some insulated wire, I'll need some more. Actually, move that first since need some electronic parts, need some low GPU structures, need simulation data. Trying to get these all in order is painstaking sometimes. Pretty much. But that's also why I questioned how many of it was just idle hours. Like if you leave the game running on overnight, or if you just leave it running for a couple of weeks straight, that really can skew the average pretty good. So this needs to drop all the way down. Well, I hope you have a lot of idle hours at your job. 77. Batteries. Some of those. Delete those. No. Understandable. I work in IT, so if I'm not just sitting around, that tends to mean something is broken. Yes, that is, I do agree with that. No. Shit, I'm gonna need some nitric acid. You do get a lot of dopamine hits. That counts for something. Wait, no. Bella, what? You're a good girl. So we got blue. Alright, let's get red. Let's get green. Now I think we can actually get the wafers. Oh goodness, low density structure as always. Just because I use the electronic parts for a lot of other stuff. Where is it, girl? I just took you outside. Do you want a treat? Is that what you want? Alright, sit. Sit. Good girl. Plastic bars. I may skip sulfur. There's plenty of other sulfur being created. Yep. We'll just skip sulfur here. So, when do you start your new job? Nice. Okay. Well, that's good. Okay, just do plastic bars. Sand. but IT job's been great. Hey, Bo. Alien dance crown time. I think some of your emojis might be broken. Yep, I've still greatly been enjoying my IT job. Making a trip in 2 weeks down for work. Though, unfortunately, I won't be streaming during that week. But I'm really looking forward to it. It'll be good to see the team again. Crush cold coke. Get speed module, steel ingot is via molten steel, copper molten, gold molten, iron molten. Yeah, that's good. Pricey this time. Yeah, 2.2, so 4. This one will need some of these. 11. 2.6. After this age, I'm probably going to go back and redo a lot of my previous setups for higher tier modules. Should be everything that we need. Just to build a rocket. all the fluids, we take care of off-site. This one is going to be a very, very high cuppa this time. Do you need to go outside? Alright, give me a minute. Bella says she needs to go outside, so I will be right back. Alrighty, I'm back. Bella's outside for a little bit. So, collectively, we need to get rocket silos going. Get some of those things going as well. Satellite I will be making manually, but I will need a rocket silo. Some beacons. Shoot, my malt filled up again. Got those two for anything that require water. Alright. Gonna build right here in this little area. Well, actually, that's a lot of truth. couple more. Midnight. This one looks like it marshals a pretty good sized force. We have the cannon turrets. That should deal pretty good damage. A lot of guns. And then yeah, just a lot of lasers. So we are. We can finally research the next age. Quantum Age. Yeah, we get advantage crushers. For sure. We will eventually get high capacity roboports. But ultimately I want to get advanced bots first. Because aside from the advanced engine, all I would really have to make is the period data and cryo. Simulate. That's actually not that difficult. The only difficult part is the computing power. Started that research, and then yeah, we'll make a beeline for these. Then we'll start upgrading all of our bots to this, because this will is like 5 times the speed. and significantly higher capacity. And that will be the final form of bots. I like the cannon because it just shoots and it just keeps on going. It doesn't stop. This was, so I'll keep this here, just because it's a lot of trees. I should go up this way, because this patch right here is going to become extremely valuable soon. So I can build me a spot right here, and it should be good. And then I can slowly advance up to here, and absorb that next. Where are you guys coming from that while you walked around? Day number 999. I should have quantum age research today. Yeah, right here. Yep, quantum age. Done before lunch. Guess since I have the space, let's go ahead and get a whole bunch of these other techs knocked out. And then we'll let the bots work on this for a minute. And I am gonna go grab the puppy. I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. We're back for the foreseeable future. Probably will have it come to right about here. So, first on the list is 112. That should take care of those. Need one advanced care, one of this. That takes care of that. Cold Coke. Basically 8. This is all copper. Relatively self-sustaining. Oh wow, we got 5,425 logistic bots now. Construction bots are steadily climbing as well. No, they're not. What the heck is this biter doing? I wonder. I wonder if I could wall him in. And they'll bring you back more bots. I'm not too worried. He'd realize he's being enclosed in. I think he broke. Anyways, back to the primary game. Wow, so it does not mind the wall, but it absolutely hates the cop who plays. Interesting. I wonder why. Anyways, we now have a pet. Complete. 6, 218. Yeah, we're at the range now. 936 plus 224. About 560. Get rid of the programming and the signals. And pick up the Exotic Industry containers. Add multiple changelog. Add the new 6x6 container. Okay. Storage size 1,000. I'm pretty sure those will eventually be useful for something. I mean, just the and below this is a couple of mechanical parts. I mean, bulk majority of it going towards the low density structures. Iron plates, iron mechanical pipes. little copper beam. Steam engines, assembly machines. Okay, so that'll make the rotors. Crushed iron, crushed copper. Getting the parts right there. One thing of ceramic. Three things of plastic. isolated wiring. Semiconductors. Six of them. Ammonia. One central processing unit. Try to leave some more spots there. Wait. Should be the rocket silos. But I need processing units for that first. Yeah. Hey, Lycan. Not terribly, but yeah, considering you're level 36, double what the limit was for beta. How have you been? And also, I'm shocked you're playing a sorcerer. What happened to the druid? I'm looking forward to being able to play it in a couple of days. I'm sorry, what was it called again? Nitric acid. Induction matrix is not really worth doing since I can't use it as an accumulator just because I can't tell the charge level off of it, and the regular accumulators are just way too slow to be of any use. Teleporters will eventually be nice to get on my own, but I have no idea how to get alien resin. Some of these research are just research to finish. Inactive. Yep, two more days. Two more days, and I can play with the rest of you. I need one unit of battery. Core computer and the two simulation data. I may be able to fit right there. Yes, it would fit. There's no way I can get data out of here. Extremely tight. And extremely cheaty. Take care of those. This actually requires a spider link. Okay. Alright, so we got ammonia. I will be right back, actually. Use the minute, get up, stretch. Alright, we're back. So we were working on trying to figure out what we needed for these two different types of gases. Water every 1 second, so I could just stick an air filter on that and call it good. So, need some ammonia gas. This is oxygen. Looks nice. There you go. Tetriac something. Making it really, really difficult to stream. Tin. So I'm basically just diluting it with water is what I'm doing. then I need a nitric acid, which is basically going to be this exact same kind of a layout. Sure. Oxygen is good. So we need at least 18 things of low density structures. Yeah. What are you barking at? What did they reply to? That's 16, so that would be close to 18 up there. And then I convert this one to a wafer factory, actually. Yeah, that would do it. Wait, what? Effects, this arc, ooh. Put that back. Fill acidic water. Unfortunate. It is greatly unfortunate. But yeah, I am surprised by how well the devs have been keeping it all under wraps for so long. It is truly going to be spectacular when it finally gets released. And honestly, even Factorio by itself has been such an amazing game. It's hard to imagine what the second game's gonna, well, the expansion's gonna be like. Alright, so does this really not take any... Okay. Yeah, there really is no guaranteed. We have amazing mods and whatnot. Alright, so that needs that. Alright, Salty wafers. They really should do better, but it gets some clicks, and unfortunately, some days, well, most content creators, that's all they're looking for is just clicks. Give me the clicks. I'll make it sound as weird as possible. And the last time I watched one of those videos, a lot of those games don't have a release date yet, or not even really confirmed. But anytime you need a rant, I'm always happy to listen. Nitric acid should be coming in soon. That is right here. That's a fail. Never mind, I need an empty. There we go. Let's see here, let me pull up my Steam wish list again. There were a few that I'm looking forward to when they're coming out. Foundry. Lightyear Frontier. Were two that I saw that I'm really looking forward to. Especially Foundry. It seems like it's satisfactory with a randomized map, which I would be extremely cool. Alright, so we got advanced. Yes, a procedurally generated map. Satisfactory is nice, but the map is static. Yes, it is the 3D. And then the other one was a Lightyear Frontier. But this is more of a farming based 3D game with some automation. And I do like me some farming games. The processing unit is on the market now. That would probably gonna... Well, it's all gonna go here. can't reach. Ah, shoot, what did I have to pick that one for? So they're all good now. Those will slowly get upgraded. I'll hold off on this one for a moment. The solid fuel. Oh, what did all? Boo, they took them. Fires automatically die after a while. I will move up here. Alright, so next on the list is the solid fuel. This. Yeah, okay, go. Five. I may need to go up to a sixth layer. Another round of attacks. You just focus on one nest at a time. Kind of just waiting for the rocket silos. Mm, 14%, not bad. Good. Okay, go. So yeah, most of all of these have already secured their 200. Why am I losing pipes? Hey, Bo, thanks for the chicken strip and the hydrate. Yeah, I seriously have no idea why I'm losing pipes. Hey, Bella. Are you ready for a bow strip? Let's get you on the big camera. Sit. Good girl. This is from Bo. Good girl. Thanks, Bo. And then here's the hydrate. A squirrel, a rabbit, a bird, the neighbor's dog, a neighbor, a random person running down the street, anything. Requires 200, so we're getting there pretty good. And I will unlock the rest of it once I get the parts I need. Nice. Hopefully they're treating your yard nice and not just like walking all the way through it. So we're also at 5,500 bots. All those dead bodies. Because the artillery keeps finding new stuff to shoot at. I keep increasing the range of it. Nice. That's good. So I have a military point here, here, and here. And the range of it is a pretty good size range. So as long as I create endpoints on the edge of my neighborhood. Ooh, we got a rocket silo. I should actually be doing pretty good. Yep. 5,583. With 616 construction bots. And I believe all of the heavy bots are out of my system. Nope, not enough. But the nice thing is we are very, very close to the next. Hey! So the next thing we are going to get is the, advanced bots. She has a very, very loud bark for sure. And it's not an aggressive bark. Her aggressive bark sounds different. All the back fur will stand up and whatnot. But yeah, we'll get Quantum Age, we'll get Nano Factories, we'll get the redefining computing, and then we'll have advanced bots. Then we'll get the entire system reset up. We're also going to have to get a moon landing soon. So I believe we get to do mining. She doesn't bark too often. Until she finds something. Asteroid mining. Anyway, so it should be giving me the rocket silo soon. I'm not sure what this is complaining. Oh, it's missing two production modules that may also be going to the laboratory. Yep. So 98% highest so far. Good girl. It is a little bit on the big side. Ooh, nice console. Potential payout, exploration satellite. And all we have is Navis orbit. I'll need 6 of them, so yes, I will need to take that whole section. Massive pipe systems. Huge pipe systems. While I think it's going to be space data obtained by launching a satellite into the Navis orbit. Space data is less than supposed, because I'll have different data types. Observation, gas, black hole, sun. We'll add a satellite here. But it dumps pretty quick. Anyways, moving on. Hypercool. This needs to empty oxygen. This needs to fill up liquid oxygen. Vastly increasing. And then this will take care of all of our liquid oxygen. Should get the jetpack mod pack again. So we got a cryo container. I want a jetpack. And I'll gladly trade my airplane for it. It's getting bad. They have evolved like medium spitters and whatnot. They have not gotten behemoth yet, but that should be coming fairly soon. Unless if I attack them first. They have not attacked, via pollution yet. Things gone. Let's see here. Evolution. 16% time, 29% pollution. Spawner is 55%. So yeah, I've killed them a lot and caused them to evolve. So if I haven't killed a single one, it probably would still be around 30%. But I would not have been able to expand. Thank goodness for all these patches of trees everywhere. This has been like the biggest tree blocker. And then in my base I have this giant section of trees. And yeah, clean these up. Anyway, alright, give me jetpacks. You know what? We'll go straight up to level 30. Yeah, I know I need a jetpack to fly. And get rid of these exoskeletons. I don't even need that anymore. Alright, so let's continue. I need 8. That would take care of that. That is, I moved off site. That is already done up there. Rocket fuel. With the 2 units. Just gonna be like plastic. Rocket fuel, kerosene. there's one. Yeah, makes no difference. Six, seven, eight. Yeah, I'm too lazy to fix it. I need to upgrade my armor. Processing units. I got my power armor. Wow, rockets fit perfect. Six. Ah, shoot. Matter these guys again. You wouldn't think I have a problem with basic inserters, but I do. Typically because I don't think I ever have enough electrical engine units. Alright, so now I have everything. Turn off my trash. All my parts. Well, that was my fault. So theoretically, I'm done. Put it in that one. The 50% I have a silo storage tank. The car. Get rid of the train. If I don't use it, let's go ahead and get rid of the balance of books. Some of this stuff was things whenever I started a new game, I just immediately put into my inventory, regardless if I need it or not. Get rid of the centrifuge, get rid of those. Did I not have the better battery researched? Oh, there it is. We'll let those churn for now. So it's gone up 12% with the newer speed modules. You guys are done. $30 to $70, I'm fine with that. Yeah, it's the threes that make everything so difficult. guess it only really does do 50. Idea how much rocket fuel I'm actually using. Hold on. So we got a cryo container. Cryotainer. Alright, so barrel size seemed to somehow screw it up. Shoot. Empty plus 500. Bug report filed. And we need to stop this madness. Cause now I somehow have... barrel size. Yeah, considering the last update was over 2 years ago, I don't think that this will... Yeah, it hasn't been touched in years. So we'll get rid of barrel size mod. Get rid of that as well. Crafting recipes with fluid ingredients now require barrels instead. Features include customized barrel capacity and stack size, hiding barrels in the player's crafting menu. That actually seems really nice. You know what? Screw it. Alright, Bo. You have a great night. Thanks for stopping by. And I will see you on Tuesday. Ah, shoot. That's what else I forgot. To use the insulated pipes. I mean, it's something I'm not 100% familiar with. I don't know what that does with everything else, since everything else now carries 50 instead of 500. I don't suppose it makes a huge game changer. Devs are getting annoyed at me. 1%. So what's holding you down? You need some more rocket fuel. Yeah. So this should be running a little bit smoother. You know what? Get the barrels. Hey, White Wolf, how are you doing today? We're working on getting a rocket launched. Ooh, good, we've got our first satellite. Had to get rid of a mod pack, unfortunately. So it was 6%. That's 4%. Had it from last night, work didn't let me sleep. Sorry to hear that. I'm doing pretty good. Really, sore from spending yesterday at the racetrack doing RC car racing. I pretty much couldn't walk this morning. Almost severely dehydrated. But all in all, doing good now. So I didn't really get anything I had planned to do today done. Hey, congratulations on being first. And thanks for the hydrate. I think next time I go out to the tracks, I am going to take at least like a gallon water. Should be more than enough. Distance. Everything seems to still be running fine despite the barrel issues. Water seems to still be churning along good. I mean, if need be, I could bump all of these up to 100. I might have to bump them all up to 100. The heck happened here? Pretty sure I don't have robot attrition turned on or anything. Alright. Oh, duh. Well, I'm a positive note, I guess it's cool that I can shove computing power into a pipe system. Granted, the pipe blows up after a while, but it still technically works. looking for liquid base. Oh, you're out producing acidic water. It'll take some of these some time to get all the extra new barrels into the system. I'm at 11%, 7%. Drilling. They might still be okay. Yeah, this is slow because it's just pure production module. I believe this is going to give us the space data we need. Sweet. 56%. So it needs half of the actual requirements to launch. So I got almost 25, so I probably have 25,000 barrels in my system so far. Going forward, all barrels will be set to 100. I guess let's go do some cleanup. I don't think lead was really used for much outside of the nuclear things. Basically almost empty, but it's still producing something. Something's a little bit better than nothing. Alright, so we'll assume we have space data and we'll assume we have high energy crystals. Liquid nitrogen will be easy enough to get. Energy crystals will have. Yeah, we'll keep making our way up here. More iron, more copper, more iron, more sulfur, another oil patch. Here's some more sulfur over here. We just need to go negotiate with the natives. Directly go up here, and then we'll build a outpost right up here. So we'll have this outpost firing. This outpost will kind of take care of down here. Then we'll have an outpost for up here. This one kind of barricades this area a little bit. Much I could do about if things come in here. So theoretically, all of them should be running at the same time. But alas, they're not. This one at least has two. This one at least has one, so it's better than nothing. Unfortunately, I don't have enough assembly machines. I'll just continue to steal from the other rockets. For now, I'm just going to take these offline. I will give it to them when they get all of the production modules. There we go, now we got a good view of it. So when it's ready, it'll launch. We need one more. The bonus will push it over to 99, and then this will push it up to 100. That's the first rocket of the game. But that only gave us like 600. Yeah. But that is enough to make 1,600 quantum age technology packs. I think that is an acceptable amount. Alright, so next time we will continue working. We will start this quantum age. Making the computing units, making some more simulation data. And then, should be next time we will have everything we need to start making the quantum age technology. I am gonna call it a good stream here. Get some good night's sleep for the next week. So, love you all. Thank you guys all for stopping on by. And I will see you again on Tuesday. I'm gonna see if there's anybody to raid real quick. We'll shoot you guys on over to high speed. Currently playing Factorio. Probably playing as the Earth mod pack. So be sure to give a good shout out, and I will see you guys later.